In this video, we are going to talk about the new AI image generator published by Microsoft, which is called MAI Image 1. They published it recently, and in this video, we are going to learn more about it, how it is, how we can use it, what are the strength points of this AI model, and then we are going to compare the ability of this AI model with Nano Banana. So if you're ready, let's just start. So here we are on their website introducing MAI Image 1 by Microsoft. And it has been on the top 10 text-to-image AI models on LMArena, which if we come here on LMRA.ai in the leaderboard here under text-to-image, you can find it as number 9. Right now it is number 9. Now, there's one thing here that I want to point out, that we cannot find MAI Image 1 here under Image Edit, because this model right now, it's only text to image, meaning it cannot edit images. We cannot, for example, like Nano Banana, tell this AI model that, hey, this is our image, just make some changes here. We can just use it to generate new images. But it's interesting. The first time that I found out about it, it was interesting for me to see what Microsoft did in this field. So, as I said, on this page, there aren't much information. There are a couple of examples, which they are really photorealistic, right? It's not like that you understand this is an AI, but and the quality is really good. Here are three examples. It is also good at text, which in a moment we will test it. And here's another example of a photorealistic image generated by MAI Image 1. There aren't much information here. So to use this, all you have to do, you can come to LMRA.ai. And when you come here, just go to a new chat. And of course you can log in so you can use LMRA as much as you want. You can come here to direct chat. Then from here, just click on this icon, generate image. And then from the top drop down here, select MAI Image 1. This is how you can use it. So now I'm going to just test it. So I wrote down, generate an image of a person speaking in front of camera in the studio. Same as what I'm doing right now. Regarding the speed of generating images, it's fast. But it's not as fast as Nano Banana, but it's still okay. So here's the result. And if you look at it, it's photorealistic. The quality of it, it's good. It understood our prompt clearly. Now, to push it further, I have prepared 10 prompts that I'm going to use these prompts on MAI Image 1 to see what it can do and how it can deliver the result. And also side by side, we are going to compare it with Nano Banana. So here are the prompts. And in each of these prompts, we are going to test something. So for example, this, the first one on level one, we are just going to have a basic object recognition, and we are going to test simple colors, minimal composition, right? To understand how this model is going to generate the result. So if we come here, I already generated them, and now we can look at the result. So the prompt was a red apple on a plate. And on the left side, we have MAI Image 1, and on the right side, we have Nano Banana. So the result we see here, let's first look at Nano Banana. It's a red apple, and it looks good, but when you look at it carefully, it's obvious it's AI. It's like it has some 3D style in it, right? It's not 100% photorealistic. But when we compare it to the result that MAI Image 1 gave us, it looks more real, right? For example, a red apple, part of it could be darker, part of it could be lighter, right? Different tones of red color. And when we look at the leaf, the quality, the texture, we can feel the material, right? Although it has some issue, I'm not sure if it is connected to this part or not. Technically, it should be. on Nano Banana version it is, but I think based on what I see, the quality of the image generated on MAI Image 1, it looks more realistic. Let's go for the next example. So here, we're gonna have a cozy coffee shop interior with wooden tables, potted plants, and sunlight streaming through large windows. Now, here we are gonna test multiple objects, arrangement, and lightings. So let's come here. This is our prompt, and this is the result. On the left side, we have MAI Image 1, and on the right side, we have Nano Banana. So on Nano Banana version, it's good, it's clear, it's understandable, everything looks fine, right? And it's acceptable, right? On the left side, we have MAI Image 1, which is somehow, it looks more cinematic, it looks more done by a photographer, a professional photographer, right? We have arrays of sunlight here. Everything seems really great. We also have some dust particles in the air. And again, it feels very, very real. Now, again, Nano Banana on this prompt was also good. So I think both of them did a really good job, but a slightly MAI Image 1 was better. The next example, the next prompt that we have, we're gonna test artistic style understanding and application. So here is an style, a design on a Japanese wood paint, okay? So on the left side, we have MAI Image 1, which if we open it, we have our design. And we also see the texture of the wood behind it, right? It's exactly like paint on the wood. But when we look at Nano Banana result, the design is good, but we don't see wood here, right? It's just like a graphic design. Now, this is the part that MAI Image 1 was way more successful. So in this prompt, MAI Image 1 performed much better comparing to Nano Banana. Let's go to task number 4, which is complex scene with action. And here we want to test dynamic movement, atmospheric effect, and time of the day. And here's a prompt, a medieval knight on horseback charging through a misty forest at dawn with rays of light piercing through the trees, right? So let's look at the result. On the right side, we have Nano Banana, which is okay, but I cannot say it's good because normally in real life, we cannot see arrays of sunlight like this. And this is not done, right? If we compare it to this one, we can see the arrays of sunlight and it feels much better that it's that regarding the time of the day, it's done, right? And just look at the action here. Look at all the soil and small particles around the horse. You can feel that this horse is just running. It's just charging forward, right? But here, that feeling, it's not really understandable. Obviously, MAI Image 1 did a better job. So till now, we can say MAI Image 1, it's much, much better at photorealistic images, okay? So when you want to generate an image that you want it to look like a photo, like a real thing happening, MAI Image 1 is the perfect choice. Let's go for the next example. So the next one, we are going to test positioning, awareness, and material rendering. So here we are gonna have three objects with three different material, actually four material. So here we have a glass sphere, wood, and some metal cylinder and a marble. I can say both of them actually did a good job. Now, let me point out to something interesting. Now here, when we look at this sphere, on the left side, meaning here, we have a window, right? It's a source of light. And if you look at the shadows, it's perfectly in the correct position, right? Here it's light, here it's dark, right? And also Nano Banana did the same thing. Here on the left side, we have a window, right? Source of light. And the shadow is in the correct position. So both of them did a really good job. Of course, the glass sphere here, it's a little bit different with this one. And I think slightly, not much, slightly May Image 1 looks more photorealistic. Let's go for the next example, which we're gonna test text integration, right? We want to see text rendering accuracy and error special styling. So let's come down here. Now in the prompt, we ask to create a vintage movie poster with this title, exact title, in bold art deco lettering featuring a 1920s actress in an elegant gown. So here's the result of May Image 1. Now the poster itself, it's perfect. The styling is perfect. The typography, the text appear really good. Here is there's a text which it's so small we cannot read it. But one thing is that the result here in this part, again, it's photorealistic, right? But on the other hand, we have Nano Banana, which it's more like a design. And here under it, we have a small text. It's slightly bigger than the other version, and it's readable. Now, both of them did a really good job, but I think in this example, Nano Banana was a little bit better. So let's go for the next example, which we're gonna test lighting and mood control, like complex lighting, atmosphere, mood, multiple light sources. So I designed the prompt in a way to make it more challenging as we go forward. So here was the part that May Image 1, the result is really good, but it has some mistakes in it, technical mistakes. So let's look at Nano Banana first. The image is good, right? We have the smoke from the cigarette here, but the wrong thing here is that part of the smoke is coming also from the lamp side, right? Which this part of it, it doesn't make sense, but everything else, it's perfect, right? Now let's look at the result here. Again, here everything looks good, but if we look at details, we see that there are some real mistakes that make this image unusable. For example, here we have some curtains on the wall, which technically it should be on the window, right? And here on the desk, we have some layers, which it's not understandable. And one other thing is that the shadow and the light on the wall coming from the lamp, it has some mysterious shadows that appear only by passing through curtain, right? But here we don't have that case, right? And this is a big mistake, meaning that at this stage, May Image 1 wasn't successful and this image is completely unusable. So it couldn't pass this level 7, lighting and mood. But let's continue and see the next three ones and see how it did. The next one is abstract concept visualization, and we want to see how these AI models can show the result using abstract design, colors, particles, and deliver the meaning. So the prompt is that a visual representation of the concept hope emerging from despair using contrast light and dark abstract shapes with warm golden tones breaking through deep blue and blacks. So here's the result. On the left side, we have May Image 1, which it's kind of really good. We have dark blacks and blue, and here we have golden emerging from there. And these lines, right? These lines show us the movement. It's just bursting out, right? But on the other hand, here we have Nano Banana version, which it doesn't show us that motion, but still it's fine. I think May Image 1 did a really, really, really good job here. Both of them are great. This one is much better. Let's go for the next example. Here we are going to test fine details and texture, macro detail, texture realism, depth of field, and subtle color work. So if we come down, we have a spider web, and it was raining, and there are water drops on it. And on the left side, we have MAI Image 1. It's really good, but my only problem is the size of this raindrop. It's too big for the spider web to handle. But if we put that aside, we can see, look, the background image is blurry, right? But we can see the real image upside down inside the backdrop, inside the raindrop, right? So you see, here's the sky, here we have sun, which is this one, then we have some green areas, some trees, which more or less we can feel it in the background. And this is really, really impressive. On the other hand, we have Nano Banana. It has less web, and it has also the problem with the size of the raindrop. It is also showing us the blurry image in the background, but again, this is not understandable. The size of it, especially this spider web, could not handle it. This one is much better, way more complex, better structure, but this one didn't. So MAI Image 1 was much better. And on our final try, we have a complex scene, right? That we have lots of elements. For example, it's a street market at night, it's raining, we have some neon signs, and we have some puddles on the floor, right? People with umbrella, flying cars, and so on and so on. And here we have, I think, steam rising from food stalls and the rest of it. So both of them are actually good. And again, I think MAI Image 1 did a better job, especially that, for example, here we have food, we have a steam coming out of it, so it followed our instructions much better. But when we look at the result here on Nano Banana, we have some steam here, but it's not coming from the food. For example, here we have food, there is no steam coming out of it, right? Here, I don't know what they have. But more or less, both of them followed the concept. The details in the MAI Image 1 were much better. So this was a quick review about MAI Image 1. I was happy with the result, especially if we want to use it for photorealistic images. It's perfect. What I'm looking for in the next version is that it can handle also image edits, right? And it can also cover some other styles, right? And I'm gonna make another video, right? Because in the leaderboard, if we check it out, let's go back to the leaderboard. If we check the leaderboard under text to image, number one is Hunyun Image 3. On the next video, right, I'm gonna make another video. I'm not sure it will be the next one. I'm gonna make another video, and I'm gonna compare MAI Image 1 with Hunyun Image 3, and I want to see how they will work, how they will design, how they will create their images. Especially the topic would be for business. For example, you want to generate some images for example, social media marketing, or for business, for apps, for whatever you have, right? Then we want to compare the result of these two AI models and see which one wins and which one we should use it for our business. So that was all for this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you have any question, leave a comment. Also, you can suggest what do you want me to make on the next video? What AI model do you want me to talk about? Or what strategy do you need me to teach you? That would be all. And I look forward to see you soon on another video.